NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the UAB Blazers and the Houston Cougars. This is where both teams need to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Cougars are not facing one of their tougher opponents, so what's the key in them not giving it away?
Well, for me, the keys are these. First, play at your own tempo. Don't get into a run-and-gun game, baby. Second of all, take care of the rock. No turnovers, baby. Turnovers only lead to easy scores the other way. And finally, play as a five-man unit defensively. Have rhythm. Be ready to rotate. Help one another on penetration.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. He throws it up from downtown. He drains it. Both teams are looking to get something going here. The power forward receives the pass. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure, just enough to force the steal.
On the dribble, gives it up. Trying to feed the block. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Boards it.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the pass play.
Got the high pick. Trying to draw some contact. Easy one. Now trying to feed the low block. Tries for two. Can't get the shot. The basket's good and the foul.
That's a big play. He was there when they needed him, baby.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Got it from the free throw line.
Ball movement, get that good spacing.
A high screen from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. He intercepts it.
Nice high post screen.
Go into the low block. Nice move with a face-up.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Houston have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
Stolen away. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
He gets the ball. In the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
A whistle and a foul. Coach not happy on the sideline. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, it's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Misses the first. Got freebies. He takes the board. Shannon handles the feed. Now they work it around the perimeter. They'll work it around the arc.
Excellent spacing. That's so important with a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Postel handles the pass. Gave it up. Kicks it out. Done. Receipt. Blocked! The point guard takes the feed. Hard foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Shot clock is dead. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Looking for a good shot. For two. And he missed. Launches it. Nope.
After one half of play, these teams are all knotted up.
Houston has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrew. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. Goes and no foul call either way.
Wow, no call. I can't believe that one.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup. Dumps it in. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job by the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
He up fakes. He's got a nice shot fake. He goes with a baby hook. He misses it. The screener got hammered trying to set that pick.
Pressure that basketball. Dump it inside.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession.
High post screen.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The land.
That's a breakdown. That'll drive the coach bananas. Hope you don't lose your hair.
Down inside. Gets it back out. For the bucket. Off the rim and no good. the outside. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
On the dribble, gives it up. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Fakes a jumper. His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely. Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Ball was loose, but the defense got possession. Easy one. And working around the perimeter.
Look at that spacing.
From three-point territory. Poor decision there to shoot that three.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
He puts in another score.
He can see the leg, Brad, and it's hanging right over the goal. Defensive pressure. Head right on the ball, drive him to the spot you like to take him and then beat him.
Puts it up. Rims out. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Doesn't go. Now they work it around the perimeter. Great defense. Dunn receives the pass.
Up and inside.
Booker handles the pass. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Goes up for two. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
There's the pick for the deuce. Can't get the shot to drop. Surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
They cut the lead to two.
Hold on to your seat, Mr. Nestler.
Moving it around the perimeter. They've got a three-point shooter spotting up. Number three is receiving great praise from the fans.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for it.
Set up, Dick.
Brad, I'm afraid to hear this crowd. If they can get a stop on this possession.
Booker wants even more support from the fans, Dick.
You know, Brad, he wants the fans backing for this defensive possession. That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow. extra time to the clock. At the end of regulation, these teams are all even.
Dick, this is everything we could ask for. It's everything that basketball fans across the country can ask for. NCAA tournament game and overtime.
I think it's going to be a heartbreak hotel for one of these clubs. I mean, heartbreak hotel. They have played their hearts out, both these clubs, executed, defended well, but somebody's going to leave here with an L.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Trying to draw the foul. Gets it to fall. Gave it up. Number 31 fakes the shot. He does the sweet fake shot with a little baby hook and off the mark. He strips him clean. Let's watch the defense down in the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
And run him right at the screen.
Layup, son. I'm telling you, Brad, you could have a field day against these guys. Let's put a uniform on.
Nobody within 10 feet of an easy basket again.
I mean, unbelievable. It's blowout city.
Tries for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Great pressure.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Booker receives the ball. Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining position because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Houston is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
On the dribble, gives it up. Jump hook from the low post. Off the rim and no good. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
For two. Contact on the shot attempt causes the misfire. The kick out. They're right on top of that pass. He attempts the three. He drains it.
You guys got the replay ready up there? Here we go.
5 points separate these two squads right now.
No one's leaving this building without a fight, Brad.
He'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
That's probably why you're out of coaching. Too many points off turnovers.
I'll tell you one thing. That leads you to the exit sign. No question. You get the Ziggy. I'll tell you, you got to protect the basketball. You can't turn it over.
The Ziggy. I love it. He makes his second shot. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
Time out on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. Let's get back out on the floor. The center gets the ball. Try to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important on how talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Gave it up. The power forward takes the feed. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
In the paint. Obvious foul. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
The ball goes out of play. Everybody into the act right now, and you can tell by the cheerleaders on the sideline how things are going.
Isn't that what makes college so special? The enthusiasm of the cheerleaders, the mascot, everybody involved.
And he scores despite the hack. Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
They shave the lead down to three.
There's a lot of time to pull this one out, Brad.
Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. You're 15 to 17 feet apart.
Shot clock is dead. Another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And the clock stopped with a foul. The front end of the 1-1. Everything looked good but the result.
They really need a score here to turn this into a one possession game.
We're ready to get back to the action. The lead trickles down to four.
Time is either your best friend or your worst enemy. Point, Brad.
Collects the rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, I'll tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Cougars opened the tournament with an impressive first-round victory.
Winning that game was so important. A big first win not only keeps the team's championship hopes alive, but does wonders to calm these kids' nerves entering the second round.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.